Hey, what's going on, ladies and gentlemen? Gamer LCD here, and today I've got another game review for you guys today. We're going old school coming off of Christmas break here, and today I've got Monster Madness Battle for Suburbia for you guys. Now, the version I'm showing you today is the PC version, but this game also comes on the Xbox 360 as well. And there's also another version of the game called Monster Madness Grave Danger for the PS3, which is kind of a knockoff of the original, but it gave you guys a whole bunch of improvements to the camera functions, as well as the gameplay and storyline elements of this game. Now that I've covered all of that, let me go ahead and explain to you guys what this game is all about. Like I said, it's called Monster Madness Grave Danger. It came out in 2007 from South Peak Games. And it's a co-op adventure game that features really, really cool cartoony characters and an engaging storyline. The whole point of this game is to kill zombies. This game really didn't do too well on, you know, the market, and I really don't understand why, because it really, really was a fun game to play with your friends, and if you didn't have any friends around, it was still an engaging single-player game. It features four different characters that you can play with through the adventure mode and four difficulty levels, and what surprised me most about this game was that as you go through the different difficulty levels, the game does progressively get harder and harder and harder, and it features new monsters as you go through. So what I want to do in this review is kind of just go through the tutorial level and show you guys what this game is all about. Once you click Adventure Mode, you have the choice of four different characters depending on what you want to play as. Each character features their own type of unique weapons, and which I found was really, really cool. I usually always pick Andy. I have beaten this game on Horror Mode and Madness Mode on the Xbox 360 a few years back, so this is actually the first time I picked up this game in a long, long time for the PC version. So I'm just going to put Thriller, which is kind of a medium difficulty, and as you pick your difficulty, you can see all these chapters that you have to go through in the game. So it's very, very cool, and it's kind of a cartoony comic book style game, so it's going to feel really, really, you know, cartoony. This game does use Unreal Engine 3, which is kind of surprising. Go ahead and skip that. At the beginning of each level, you kind of have this cool cinematic that you can watch. I gotta grab my specialty melee weapon here. Like I said, each character gets its own type of different weapon type they go through.
Now that you've got your specialty melee weapon, head back to the front door and prepare for battle.
In order to attack, all you do is hold down the right trigger, or click the right trigger.
Yeah, this is fun!
And like I said, really the whole point of this game is to just have a really cartoony comic book style game here and to kill zombies along the way.
Defend yourself. When your power meter is charged with a thumbs up weapon, hold the right trigger for a special character attack.
Now, if you guys want to play online in this game, there's really not that many people playing online. You probably might find one or two people, maximum, when you try to log on to this thing. But the really only way to play online in this game is to actually get a whole group of people together online through forums and other means. So you gotta get your online stuff. Like I said, this game is very, very cheap. You probably pick it up on eBay for around $5, depending on your console or platform. I picked up the PC version for around $3, I believe it was, on a special auction, so that was kind of cool. You also have grenades that you can throw. Click the left thumbstick. Well, I'm using the Xbox 360 controller, but I use the left thumbstick to strafe back and forth. Like I said, this is a co-op game, so you can have a maximum of up to four people playing with you at once. Or three people, including yourself. So. Uh-oh. Oh, yeah. Killing zombies. As you go through the different levels, you have a whole bunch of varying different zombie bosses that you have to defeat. And they're actually really all greatly designed. Meaning that they become progressively harder. Most objects in this game are interactable, so like you just saw there, I activated the lawnmower and it will attack my opponent for me if it hits it. Oh, I'm gonna die. I need some drink. You regenerate health in this game by picking up those special, like, drinks. Hit him with my freaking... Now, you probably notice me picking up all these different, like, forks and different clocks and tools and stuff of that nature. Well, those parts can be used later down in the game to craft different weapons. Where'd he go? There he is. Where's the lawnmower? I'm gonna die. Oh, I killed him. Sweet.
Oh, you're dead. Again.
Oh, I'm gonna kill myself. And there you guys have it. That was basically the tutorial level of Monster Madness Battle for Suburbia, which is Zach's house. So I hope you guys enjoyed this little preview of this game. Like I said, it is kind of old. Came out in 2007. But it is still a really fun game to go play and pick up every once in a while. Even if you haven't played it before, I encourage you to do so because it really is a fun game and you'll really enjoy the comic book kind of style gameplay of this game. So I'm going to go ahead and exit to the main menu, guys. Like I said, you can pick this game up very, very cheap. If you have any questions about it, go ahead and hit me up on YouTube, private message me, or comment in the comment section. My name is GamerLCD. Go ahead and subscribe to my YouTube channel for more content like this, and I will see you guys next time. Thanks for watching.